Hello, my dear students of class 11. Welcome to English literature class. Dear students, you studied two poems by now. First one, you studied the dolphins, and the second was the gift of India. Now, today you will study the next poem. But you can say poem number 6, John Brown, written by Bob Dylan. Here, what is written in the poem? John Brown, you listen it carefully, and in the next time I'll explain the poem. Here, try to understand. John Brown is a ballad, you can say, and is an anti-war poem like The Gift of India. The poem opens on a dramatic note. Very interesting and very, very easy poem. We are told about John Brown. The poet told us about John Brown and his mother. The poet told us about John Brown and his mother. John Brown went off to war in some foreign country. His mother was proud of him as he was going far off. Far off means foreign country. His mother was proud of him. She had a broad smile on her face on seeing her son in the uniform of a soldier. As he was going in foreign country for a war, so he was in soldier's uniform. So his mother had a broad smile on her face on seeing her son in the uniform. She expressed her feelings of happiness and pride on his being able to hold a gun and fight the enemy. She advised him to obey his captain. As he was a soldier, John Brown was a soldier, has become a soldier. So, his mother advised him to obey his captain. She hoped he would win lots of medals, which they would proudly hang on the wall on his return home. He hoped that after the war, for his bravery, he would get so many medals which they would hang on the wall of their house. They would proudly hang on the wall on his return home. The When John Brown's train started, his mother shouted to tell everyone in the neighborhood about her sons going to war. She informed in her neighborhood His mother shouted to tell everyone in the neighborhood about her sons going to war as a soldier. She got some letters from her son for some time. In the beginning, she got some letters from her son from the foreign country where he went off for a war. Sometime she got some letters she proudly showed to her neighbors. You see, my son has sent a letter in a smile way, smiling face, having a smile on her face, and boasted about her son's uniform. Boasted about her son's uniform and gun. She almost made fun of those who called war something old-fashioned. She made ridicule to those who called war something old-fashioned. That is a very old-fashioned thing. For such type of people, she made fun. Then she received no letter. After some month, she received no letter from her son for some time. One day she got a letter telling her that she should go to the station to receive her son. In a letter it was written that his son was coming and she should come at the station to receive him. She smiled and went to the station. She looked around everywhere. She looked around but failed to spot her son. She could not see where his son was at the station. As all the passengers went away, she saw her son at last. When the platform became empty, when there was no one at the station, she saw her son. But she could not believe her eyes. His face was totally disfigured. His son's face was totally disfigured. He had lost one of his hands in war. He wore medals and a metal brace around his waist. He spoke in very low voice. His mother could not recognize even his face because his face was totally deformed. The mother asked her son what happened to him in the war. John Brown tried to talk. He wanted to talk to his mother. He could hardly open his mouth. It was very difficult for him to open his mouth. The scene was so repulsive that the mother had to turn her face away. She could not tolerate her son's face, the condition of his son's face. At last the son spoke. He reminded his mother how she thought that the best thing that had happened was his going to the war. He said to his mother that you thought that the war is very good thing. No. He said that she felt proud of him as he was fighting. He wished she should have been in his place. He wished she should have been in his place. Then she would know how the war is terrible and horrible. She had no idea how the wars are repulsive, destructive. She doesn't know. If she would at his place, then she would know what how the war is horrible and terrible. The son continued to speak. He said that he wondered what he was doing in the war. Trying to kill someone or die doing so. What frightened him the most was when the enemy soldier stood in front of him. He said to his mother, what frightened him the most was when the enemy soldier stood in front of him. He saw that his face resembled his. He was like him. His enemy was also like him. There was no difference at all between the enemy and him. In the midst of explosive sounds of shells bursting and stink from the dead bodies, he realized that he was just a puppet in a play. In the midst of explosive sounds of shells bursting and stink from the dead bodies, foul smell, stink from the dead bodies, he realized that he was just a puppet in a play. He had no will of his own, no will of his own. Through the roaring sound and smoke, a cannonball took his eyes away. And he became blind. He turned away to walk. He did not want to go home. He did not want to go to his home. He turned away to walk. His mother was still in a shock as she saw the metal brace that helped his son stand. He could not stand on his own. He has become lame without leg. He called his mother close and dropped his medals into her hand. called his mother closer and dropped his medals. What he got from the war, from winning the war. He defeated the enemy. He got the medal. He got the medal and he dropped his medal into his mother's hand. Because the war was futile. Though he defeated his enemy, but he was not happy. As his mother hoped that his son would get so many medals, so he gave the medals in the hand of his mother and went out. That was the outline, you can say, summary of this poem. I will explain the poem tomorrow. So you please sit with your poetry book, Reverie. I will explain it tomorrow. Thank you, students. Thank you so much.